Pietro mio, to my singular delight, I have received a letter from you and have taken note of what you write to me. I know it is your desire to obtain two lines from my hand, despite the anxiety I have to please and content you. I make amends with these few lines that hopefully will bring you some little consolation and peace of mind. I beg you all I can to accept my goodwill towards you, which I can testify is ever most bent upon your gratification and service. Your Duchess of Ferrara, Lucrezia.
Your Ladyship, I believe there is need for your penetrating intelligence that serves you so well to arrange our meeting. Your hand I kiss in supplication. Farewell.
Pietro mio, I do confess I am unable to render thanks for your great courtesy. My heart is set on convincing you that nothing can prevent me from adoring your name. I take the trouble for love, and I shall remain as obliged to you as you deserve. I wait your reply with great anticipation and prepared for your command. Lucrezia Borgia, Ferrara, 8th of June 1503.
Today, I would have come to pay tribute to your ladyship, as was my obligation and my desire, both vast and infinite, had it not been that the other night I walked with such pain in my neck that now I can only move it if I turn my entire body. I shall straight away come to your ladyship within 2 days. I shall come in any case, as I have no desire to follow this neck ache with heartache, although I fear I am already affected, seeing that I have delayed more than I should wish my coming to kiss your hand. Accordingly, I shall come quickly whatever happens, if only to cure myself of this second malady. Here, the heat is unusually intense, and I seem to be all aflame and turned to fire. I do not know whether you feel it to the same degree. Craving your favor, I kiss your hand.
Pietro mio, I shall not deny that for its spark of yours, untold volcanoes like Etna are raging in my breast. But truly, I can do no sin. Let love just revenge for me, not because I am able to tell you what tender bitterness enfolds me at this parting. Do I write to you, light of my life, but also to entreat you to cherish yourself more dearly. They say each has a good angel who prays for them, and I pray to that angel for you. All I know is that faith, as pure and as constant as mine, desires the favor of your goodness. Farewell, your Duchess.
my dearest life. I am leaving, and yet I do not leave and never shall. I dare not speak to you, but truly, of all who love, none more blessed than I. And what sweeter miracle could be wrought than this, to live in another and die in oneself? And oh, how truthfully I can swear I live in you. All these nights, whether in my dreams or lying awake, all these long nights, I was with you. I hope it will be the same every night of my life. My heart kisses your ladyship's hand, which so soon I shall come to kiss with these lips that are forever forming your name, or rather, with this very soul, which even now is telling me that at that instant it will want to leap to my lips, and so take sweet revenge for its sweet wound. 8th of July, 1503.
Pietro mio, long ago I could pick up this pen to thank you for the most noble and gracious service you performed with your healing visit yesterday to my house and to my very bedside. The truth is, your visit has rid me of all the faintness of fever I had, as if some celestial being had been sent down from above to cure me. Those dear sweet words, so full of love and joy, I shall treasure the memory along with others I have stored in my mind. Your kisses were sweet and lovely. I do not say lovelier, for lovelier could not be. Your Duchess, Ferrara, August 1503.
As long as there is life in me, no other woman could ever again enter my thoughts, for none could rival you in excellence. And were I even lose my life in thus consigning myself to the flames, it would still be well with me to enjoy a special benediction. Not chance, nor fortune, not place, nor time, not the world entire, and not even you can alter this resolve. Now I feel that I can write so many things to you for which I could not find words yesterday when my pure love inflamed. And if it happens that you cannot read my feelings in my eyes and upon my countenance, what use may I suppose you could have for letters? Think me false as much as you will. Believe the truth as little as you please, but like it or not, the day shall come where you must acknowledge how much you've judged me wrong. In supplication, I kiss your hand. Venice, October 1503.
Pietro mio, I accept every excuse which you offer, and I cannot help wishing for those letters now that I am seeing them and speaking with them to be pillars sustaining my life. The thought, the memory of you encircles my heart, its day, its night, every hour, whatever my condition. You can imagine how much delight your letters give me. I extend to you all thanks I can, and I long for your sweet kisses. Your Lucrezia.
fate keeps me against my will. Yet, I have no fear that I could cease to love you and not count you the one and only dear mistress of myself and my life, a valiant and steadfast lover who serves with the purest and warmest loyalty the woman he loves and honors above all things human. I do beseech you, never to alter and never to lose heart in this love, though there are so many things which obstruct and oppose our desires. A thousand harsh and conflicting things, a thousand separations, a thousand watchmen, a thousand barriers, and a thousand walls cannot possess this great beauty of love. It is more magnanimous and more admirable. It is the mark of a great and exalted heart. I love you, and nothing can take this from me. And when that day comes, it will be so lovely and precious for us to recall that we were staunch and constant lovers, and it will seem to us that we are only truly happy because we share this memory. I could fly with my departed spirit and be near you always. I should desire no more to live. I kiss your gentle hand by which my heart is bound. And more, if you so let me be so bold, I plan to kiss upon one of those prettiest and brightest and sweetest eyes of yours which have pierced me to the soul. Farewell.
Pietro mio, I shall write no more, except to assure you once more of my continuing goodwill towards you. Your Duchess of Ferrara, Lucrezia Borgia.